Hello students, welcome to the next class. So in the previous class we have discussed the lab under large sample test. So we have many types of large sample test. Under that, the first one we have completed, that is the single proportion. So the test of significance based on the single proportion, we have seen how to perform the test of significance and deriving the test statistic for the single proportion drawn from only single population. And the various some problems, we have given some problem for homework also. So hope you all have done that problem. And today we will discuss the next test under the large sample test. So our second test is test for two proportions. Second one is test for two proportions. So you can call it as test of significance for the difference of two proportions. Here two proportions means here we are going to check the two different population proportions. So we are going to test the two different populations respect to the certain attribute. So we compare two different population proportions. We are going to compare the two different population proportions with respect to only some certain attribute. So same like the one proportion or the single proportion, based on one attribute, the presence or absence of attribute, we have divided as success and failure. So in the same way, we compare two different populations or the population. So we compare two different populations based on some certain attributes. Not population proportions. So we compare populations by using the proportions. We are not going to compare the population proportions. We are going to compare two different populations, whether those two populations are equal or not, by using the certain attribute based on the proportions. Now let and we know that let x1, here we are going to have two populations. So we'll be getting two proportions also. So x1 and x2 be the number of observations. So x and x2 be the number of persons having an attribute. So generally we consider x as the success, right? So here x1 and x2 be the number of persons having an attribute. So we consider one attribute. So the presence of an attribute in the first population. So in the first population, number of persons having an attribute is x1. In second population, number of persons having an attribute is x2. And next we consider the sample sizes n1 and n2 attributes of sizes n1 and n2 respectively. So from the sizes, so out of the in the first population we took the sample of size n1. Out of those n1 values, x1 are success. Similarly, the second sample, the n2, we took the sample size of n2. So among these n2 values, x2 are the number of success for the second sample. So from two different populations, so let x1 and x2 be the number of persons having an attribute of from the sizes n1 and n2 respectively from two populations. So from two different populations, we are going to consider two different samples, and we are going to consider x1 and x2 as the success, that is having an attribute, in the sample 1 and sample 2. So we know that obviously this follows the binomial distribution, right? So obviously x1 and x2 both follows the binomial distribution. Both follows the binomial distribution. So generally, if any one variable you have, x follows the binomial distribution, we are going to write the parameters as n, p, that is capital P. Here, two different populations are there. So first, x1 follows binomial with n, p, right? So here, n means the sample size of the first sample, that is n1, the population proportion we are denoting with capital P. So we are going to write for the first population. So that's why I'm writing denoting with P1. So your x1 follows binomial with n1, p1, and similarly x2 follows binomial with n2, p2. So here expectation of x1 equals to, what is the mean of binomial distribution? Expectation of x equals to np and variance of x equals to npq. So here np means n1, p1 and variance of x1 equals to n1, p1, q1. Similarly, here expectation of x2 equals to n2, p2 and variance of x2 equals to n2, p2, q2. So what is q1 and p1 here? Here q1 equals to 1 minus p1 and here q2 equals to 1 minus p2. So this is the variance of the x1 and variance of x2. Now this is the basic introduction related to the two proportions. That means you are going to compare two different populations based on one attribute by using the differences of proportions. Here the test statistics we are going to perform based on the difference of two proportions. So this is the first proportions we know. First we have to write our proportions also, right? So the sample proportions, these are the only population values. Now write down the sample proportions. Sample proportions, we are going to have two sample proportions. First one is P1, which is equals to X1 by N1, and P2 equals to X2 by N2. So what is P1? It is the proportion of the first sample. The first sample proportion is small p1, which is equals to number of success by total sample size. So number of success means x1, the total sample size is n1, and p2, it is this proportion of the second sample, which is equals to number of success of the second sample divided by total number of observations in the second sample, that is x2 by n2. So we got our sample proportions also. Now next is we are going to find our, before finding the test statistics, what is the first step? We have to formulate our null hypothesis and also the alternative hypothesis. So write the notes carefully. So what is the null hypothesis we are going to write? We are going to, in the single sample, we have written null hypothesis P equals to P0, that is some specified value of P. Null hypothesis. So basically, what is a null hypothesis? Whenever you compare two things, or whenever you compare two populations or two procedures, what is the null hypothesis we are going to write? There is no difference between the two populations or two procedures like that. So here we are going to compare the two populations by using their proportions, right? So here null hypothesis, it is denoted with H naught, and under H naught what we are going to write? P1 equals to P2. So we are comparing two populations. What is P1? Proportion of the population or the probability. Second one is second population probability or the proportion of the second population. So generally what we write, there is no significance difference between the two population proportions. So population proportions are denoted with P1 and P2. So that's why under H naught we write H naught such that P1 equals to P2. That is, there is no significance difference. There is no significance difference between the two population difference between the two population proportions. Two population proportions. Next, after null hypothesis, we are going to define the, so there is no alternative hypothesis will define, and if you observe here, there is no difference between two population proportions, means two population proportions are equal. We will be writing two population proportions, or you can write in this way, there is no difference you can write, or you can write two population proportions are equal. Next, write down the alternative hypothesis. So, alternative hypothesis, what we are going to define with H1. So, H1 such that P1 not equals to P2. So, P1 not equals to P2 means there is a significance difference between two sample proportions. Or generally, alternative hypothesis can be written in three ways. One is for two tail, next P1 greater than P2 is the right tail. So this one is the two tail, this one is the right tail, and one more alternative hypothesis you can write is H1 such that P1 less than P2. So this is the left tail. So what does it mean? Both are not equal means there is a significance difference. That is, there is a significance difference between the two population proportions. Between the two population proportions. That means there is a difference between two population proportions means you can write as both population or the two population proportions are not equal. So this is the defining our null hypothesis and the alternative hypothesis. Next, we have to define the level of significance. So level of significance should be a fixed and a predefined value before taking the sample only. So generally level of significance we consider as alpha. Next step is we have to write our test statistic. So generally if T is any statistic, what is the test statistic given as? Generally it is equals to Z equals to T minus expectation of T by standard error of T follows the normal distribution with 0, 1. So here, what is T? What is our test? What is the statistic? we are going to take consider two proportions by considering the difference of the proportions. So consider the standard normal variate for difference of proportions. Consider the standard normal variate. Consider the standard normal variate for difference of two proportions. Difference of two proportions. So a difference of two proportions means it should be a sample proportions only, because p means always statistic which relates to the sample values only. So consider the standard normal variate for the difference of two proportions. If you get confused, write down here two sample proportions. Two sample proportions. So difference of two sample proportions means p1 minus p2. So this is the statistic we are going to use for the considering the test statistic. So what is the test statistic now? Z equals to, so in place of p, what we have to write? p1 minus p2. That is p1 minus p2 minus expectation of p1 minus p2 divided by standard error of p1 minus p2, which follows the normal distribution with 0, 1. So in this way we are going to write the test statistic, but we want the values of expectation of p1 minus p2 and standard error of p1 minus p2. So now we will find the expected and the standard error values for our difference in the proportion. So first we'll consider expectation of p1 minus p2 and find out the value for expectation of p1 minus p2. So first we consider expectation of p1 minus p2. So expectation of p1 minus p2 equals to expectation of p1 minus expectation of p2. So how we'll find the expectation of p1 and p2 values? So since expectation of p1 equals to, what is the p1 value? Expectation of x1 by n1, which is equals to 1 by n1 is constant, expectation of x1. So what is expectation of n1 equals to, which is equals to 1 by n1 into n1 into p1. So n1 and n1 and x cancel. Expectation of p1 is equals to the population proportion p1. Similarly, expectation of p2 is equals to, expectation of p2 value is x2 by n2. So 1 by n2 is constant. Expectation of x2. So expectation of x2 value is n2 p2. n2 gets cancelled. Expectation of p2 equals to capital P2, that is population proportion. So now we got the expectation of P1 and expectation of P2. Now we'll substitute these values in expectation of P1 minus P2 equals to, what is expectation of P1? Capital P1 minus expectation of P2 is capital P2. So we got the required expectation of P1 minus P2 value. Now, next we have to get the variance. So, standard error of P1 minus P2. So next we want the standard error of P1 minus P2. So standard error equals to root over variance of P1 minus P2. So first we consider the variance of, so I'm going to consider variance of P1 minus P2. So what is variance of P1 minus P2? We know this are all the independent observations. So variance of P1 plus variance of P2. So since P1, P2 are independent, the covariance term will become zero. So generally variance of x minus y, what is the formula? Variance of x plus variance of y minus 2 into covariance of x comma y. Here if x and y are independent, covariance will become zero. So here also the proportions are independent, that's why variance of p1 minus p2 equals to variance of p1 plus variance of p2. Now we have to find the variance of p1 value. Variance of p1 equals to, variance of p1 value is x1 by n1. So what is the variance of a constant? It's square. So 1 by n1 square into variance of x1. What is variance of x1 value? 1 by n square into n1 into p1 into q1. So this is equals to variance of p1 equals to n1, and 1 n1 gets cancelled. So p1 into q1 divided by n1. So this is the variance of the first sample proportion. Similarly, variance of p2 is equals to variance of x2 by n2. Variance of a constant is its square, which is equals to 1 by n2 square variance of x2. So variance of x2, what is variance of x2? N2 into p2 into q2. N2 and 1 n2 gets cancelled. So variance of p2 is equals to p2 q2 by n2. Now substitute this variance of p1 and variance of p2 value in variance of p1 minus p2. So therefore variance of p1 minus p2 is equals to, what is the value? Variance of p1 is capital P1 q1 by n1 plus capital P2 capital Q2 by n2. So this is nothing but variance of P1. If you apply root to it, we get the standard error. That is, therefore standard error of P1 minus P2 equals to square root of the above value. That is square root of the P1 Q1 by n1 plus square root of the, sorry, plus p2 q2 by n2. So this is the required standard error value, this is the expected value. Now we will substitute the values in the test statistics. Now the test statistic, is given as, so what is the general test statistic? Z equals to P1 minus P2 minus expectation of P1 minus P2 divided by standard error of P1 minus P2 follows the normal distribution with 0, 1. Substitute expectation of P1 and standard error of P1 minus P2 values. so that z equals to so p1 minus p2 as it is minus what is expectation of p1 minus p2 value we got it as capital P1 minus capital P2 divided by what is the standard error value? Standard error value we got it as square root of P1 Q1 by N1 plus P2 Q2 by N2 which follows the normal distribution with 0, 1. So this is our general test statistics. So next step what we are going to do, we are going to write the test statistic under the null hypothesis. Copy it in here. So under null hypothesis we have some condition, that is P1 equals to P2. So based on that condition, we are going to write our test statistic. So the test statistic under H0. Now, the test statistic under H0. So what is H0? P1 equals to P2. So P1 equals to P2, I am assuming as some value equals to P, say. So the test statistic under H0 says that P1 equals to P2, then what is the Q1? Q1 equals to also Q2, which is equals to some value Q is given as. So if P1 equals to P2, so in this test statistic, if P1 equals to P2 means this term will become 0. So P1 equals to P2 is P, P minus P, 0. So Z equals to small p1 minus small p2 divided by, here substitute P1 equals to P, Q1 equals to Q by N1 plus P2 equals to P, Q2 equals to Q divided by N2. So this is equals to P1 minus P2 divided by square root of, so from these two terms I can take out PQ common, PQ into 1 by N1 plus 1 by N2. So this is the required test statistic under the null hypothesis, that is Z equals to P1 minus P2 divided by square root of PQ into 1 by N1 plus 1 by N2. So sometimes what happens is your population proportion is there, right? Population proportion P value, that value will be unknown. So we will be not knowing the population proportion value. So if this capital P is unknown, that means the population proportion value is not provided, then we estimate that value. Then we estimate it as, so estimated values always we denote with hat, right? Estimate as P hat equals to N1 X1 plus N2 X2 by, sorry, N1 P1 plus N2 P2 divided by N1 plus N2. So we know that since we know P1 equals to X1 by N1, from this N1 P1 equals to X1. Similarly P2 equals to X2 by N2, so from this N1 P1 equals to X2. So here in case of N1 P1 we can write X1 and N2 P2 we can write X2. so that the p value can be estimated by using the formula x1 plus x2 by n1 plus n2. And similarly, q hat equals to 1 minus p hat. Then the test statistic is given as, then the test statistic is given as, so how we will write the test statistic? Z equals to p1 minus p2 divided by square root of, here we are going to substitute the estimated values, that is p hat q hat into 1 by n1 plus 1 by n2, follows the normal distribution with 0 comma 1. So this is the test statistic for the two proportions. Now we'll write the conclusions. The conclusion will be similar. So the same conclusion, we are going to compare the calculated value with the table value. So conclusion, what is the conclusion? Compare mod z calculated value with the z alpha at z tab value at alpha percent level of significance. So if mod z calculated value is greater than z tab at alpha percent level of significance, then what we do? Calculated is greater than the table value. So which implies we reject the null hypothesis, that is H0. Otherwise if mod Z calculated is less than or equals to Z tab at alpha percent level of significance, then we accept the null hypothesis H0. So this is the conclusion for the two proportions. The conclusion will be same. So reject H0 means, what is the rejection of H0? H0 is two proportions are equal. So reject H0 means two proportions, population proportions are not equal. If mod Z calculated is less than or equals to Z tab, we accept the H0, that is there is no significance difference between the two population proportions. So in the next class we'll discuss the problems based on the two proportions.